Hey, welcome back to Virtual. In this episode, I'll show you how I apply ReLusion's Actor Core mocap to a metahuman in UE4. This is a fantasy village pack that we downloaded off the Epic Marketplace. I went to Quixel Bridge to look for a character. Omar looked pretty interesting, so I chose him. I imported Omar into UE4. I'm in my web browser now, browsing ReLusion's Actor Core mocap library. Earlier I found something really awesome in Assassin's Moves, so I went to go look for the individual clips. I click download, select export motion only, and search for iClone and download to the smart gallery. Back in iClone, you go to their smart gallery plugin and browse for your new animations. In your content browser under animations, you find your new folder. I set up a live link between Unreal Engine 4 and iClone. That means whatever animation happens in iClone will happen in Unreal Engine 4. ReLusion has a tutorial page where they show you exactly how to set up the live link between Unreal Engine and iClone. There is a process to setting up the live link, but no worries, the second and third time you do it, it's really easy. It's not that hard if you follow the videos. They'll show you how to set up the MetaHuman blueprint, do a few changes in the body animation, and they'll give you a few files that you need to bring into your project. Here in iClone, I'm going to show you how I set up the animation sequence using the Actor Core clips. Drag and drop the animation clip onto the character. Slide the cursor to the end of the timeline and select the next animation clip. Align them and check that the transition is smooth. Next, I'm going to add the start of the running scene. For this animation, I wanted the character to start running as he gets up. So I'm going to trim my animation. Next, I'm adding the sneak loop. I didn't want the animation to be quite as long, so I'm going to trim it shorter and add an end. His feet's not lining up correctly. Whoa. Oh, that's the slide. That means we have to reapply this. And a little idle sequence in the end. There you have it. It's quite quick and simple. Now it's time to activate the Unreal Engine Live Link. Don't need the spotlight, directional light, or cameras. We have our character selected, and now we activate the link. Back to Unreal Engine 4, and now play back the animation. You can also record the animation and use it in Unreal Engine 4. Simply go to the take recorder, add your MetaHuman, go back to iClone and make sure your animation is at the beginning, and then click record and wait for the countdown. As soon as it hits zero, play your animation. Once it's done and you're satisfied with the result, stop and you have your animation. Once the sequence has saved, go to your cinematics takes and find your animation track. And here you have the animation. I can close the live link. Oh, wait. You will most likely receive this problem. yeah, it's a known problem with the animation track. You simply go in to your animation sequence, go down to body, to the body animation properties, find that body animation, and then retarget the animation to your bone, current bone structure. Go to male, medium, narrow weight body, save, close, and then the animation will be perfect. Voila.